Dude, I don't think you have an idol.
After I hear that people are saying Jason's name, I'm thinking, I like the guy and I want to work with him, and he also feels familiar to me, and he reminds me of an ex-boyfriend that I feel is a very authentic, good guy that I could trust. And so I felt that, and it's like, I want to work with that. So what's the first thing I do? I go to him and I tell him that was me. I got up and got soaking wet. It's like, there should be that sense of urgency to help ourselves and not just sit like lazy and selfish. Yeah. And I didn't go to sleep last night for us. Like, people can't just sheep around anymore. This is not fair. And Molly doesn't do, she's that catty girl in high school that's like popular and pretty that all the guys like, but you as a girl can see through.
You're cute, Jason.
The three, like at the top, the king, the queen, and the jack, the royal party, they're the popular group that everyone's like, we're not worthy, we're not worthy, we want to fit in with you. And me and Jason are the underdogs, the misfits, the nerds. It's like high school all over again.
Wow.
Absolutely.
Revenge of the Nerds takeover happens now.
The freaks and geeks, the freaks and geeks. Like, don't dance. Sorry. Yeah, play cool.
I stick out. I don't like to stick in, honestly. And when I don't fit in, I'll be like, well, forget these people, I'm gonna fit out. And I've done that. And most of my life, I have been on the outs. And that has actually given me a lot of success in my life because I've said, you know what, I'm not gonna follow the crowd, I'm gonna do my own thing. And as an entrepreneur, you know, it can be beneficial. You know, I'm not married, I don't have kids, I'm single. And, you know, you start to look back at your actual life and realize like, okay, some of the problems happening in my actual life are being magnified in this game.
Molly, sorry, it's time to put an end to your reign, my queen. It's time for the misfits and the nerds and the outsiders to finally feel like they belong.
Second person voted out. Molly.
One of you must come to the island of the idols.
I would go.
We're here to play this game, and I'm a risk taker. I mean, I quit my job as a CPA to become an entrepreneur. So to me, it was like, no brainer, I want to go. Like, I'm going to the island of the idols, and I get to figure out what this is about.
I'm excited, like, we're going to have some fun.
I see first a man's face. It's a kind of handsome man's face. To me, you're like, this kind of looks familiar. Wow, Boston Rob and Sandra. I can't believe no one else jumped on this. These are experts that are coming to you. I am not a typical Survivor player. I feel like a novice in this game. And if it's anyone, I need these guys. In that moment, I'm like, I'm in the right place at the right time.
Different people need different types of persuasion. You could appeal to like someone's ego.
Yeah, that helps.
You could try to scare someone, put fear into them to get what you want.
That's
or
true.
For me, rumors. You start a rumor.
I know, you're so good at that.
What about this for that? You're offering them something in return for something else.
Yeah, that's more me. Mine is more intellectual of a connection.
When you first got here, we told you that there'd be an opportunity to test what you learned.
Okay.
We actually have some insight into your next immunity challenge. If you can persuade your tribe to let you be the caller, you will earn an advantage that allows you to block the vote of another player. If you fail to end up in the caller role, you lose your vote for the next tribal council.
I love this.
You're going to accept the test.
I'm doing it. Cool. I'm doing it no matter what. I'm not thinking twice. I'm gonna push to be the person that calls it out. All right, so basically, I get there and get an advantage in the next immunity challenge that will benefit you and your tribe. They basically gave us what the next immunity challenge is in detail. There's only one twist. It says that you guys have to unanimously agree on the role that I play in that challenge.
Okay.
Then I can tell you all the details.
How can we assign you a role without you telling us what the challenge is?
I basically just say, yes, we unanimously decide that Noura can pick the role to do, and then I get to tell you the whole detail, and you'll see that that's why I need that role. I'm doing the this for that. The idea is, oh, you want to know this information I have? Well, I need this commitment from you guys. Like, the role I want to have is the calling position.
Right, okay.
Right now, they're not believing in me. They're questioning me. And honestly, I don't think I'm that bad of a caller. I feel like I have a big mouth, a big voice. Even if I was the worst caller, if we're practicing ahead of time and we know what we're going into, I think we should be fine. Take 30 steps forward and keep going. There's nothing in front of you. Janet, take one step to your right.
Oh my God.
He's not going to race.
Okay, you have one extra person. Got to sit somebody out. Who's it going to be?
Here we go.
Noura.
Noura. Okay.
You are sitting out.
Noura.
You're sitting out.
My tribe told me to sit out. So after all that, I lost my vote at the next tribal council. This might blow up my game. This is a freaking nightmare.
Vokai has it! Vokai wins immunity!
Everybody, drop your buffs.
For the new Lyro tribe, we have five former Vokai. We've got Noura, Kelly, Jamal, Jack, and Janet, and three former Lyro with Tom, Dean, and Karishma.
Tonight is somewhat simple. The only monkey wrench in there is when I went to the Island of the Idols, I lost my vote for tonight. So that puts us 4-3. But thank God, we still have the numbers. I feel so lucky. So now you got these three people and you're like, do we go with the weakest person to get out so we do better in winning as a tribe? Or do we just get rid of like the threats now so when we go to the merge, we don't have to deal with them then?
Fifth person voted out. Tom, that's five, that's enough. Need to bring me your torch.
Tribal went according to plan. Tom went home. So now we're sitting pretty with five Vokai and two Lyro. And you think, this is so simple, let's take out, you know, Karishma or Dean. But the players I don't trust are actually Jamal and Jack. They're the guys that were gunning for me on my old tribe. And I know I can't work with those guys and I gotta kill them before they kill me.
Jeff, I think I got a little something.
Why wouldn't you play last?
Any votes cast for Dean will not count.
Playing this for Noura.
You are? Oh my God.
Jack, seventh person voted out, the first member of our jury. Jack.
Who was the other Jack?
Who was the other Jack?
I thought that Dean might have an idol, so I had to vote someone today, and it ended up being Jack. And that didn't come just from me. It was kind of like advice for my best interest, like that I had to put Jack.
Who told you to write Jack's name?
I do feel indebted to you. Jamal, you saved my ass with that idol. It's Kelly, I'm sorry.
Grab your purse.
Tonight, I'm voting for D-A-N, Dan. What really made it simple for me is he's made a lot of women feel uncomfortable. He's kind of pushed the boundaries of, you know, snuggling at night and, you know, being flirtatious. This is not okay. We're not gonna wait to get to the end and then have some talk about his behavior. We're gonna do this now.
Eighth person voted out, the second member of our jury. Kelly.
Noura wins immunity for purple.
Keep going.
Noura, come on over. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Immunity is yours. You cannot be voted out of the game tonight. Congratulations. Head back.
I have to hug you?
Of course. Congrats.
Janet has been on the chopping block for a while, but Aaron's such a physical and social threat, and he didn't win the necklace today. So he's like a deer in the woods that's just unattended, alone, no people by his side. We have a clear shot. Like, why would we not take it?
10th person voted out, the fourth member of our jury, Aaron.
Noura wins individual immunity again.
Well, there are a few milestones in this game.
Oh my God.
Surviving a switch.
Oh my God.
Making the merge. Crafting your first blindside, and this moment right here.
I'm gonna freak out.
It's time for some love. Yeah. Noura, let's get your sister Lana out here. Yeah. Come on, Lana.
Yeah. I'm proud of you. That's all I ever wanted.
I knew
you'd
be here.
That's all I ever wanted. I know.
I knew you'd be here.
That's all I ever wanted.
Noura, your sister just said I'm proud of you, and you said that's all I've ever wanted.
Yeah. I'm the big sister, but I want to be like her when I grow up. And in my adulthood, she's been my big sister. And I know I'm impulsive and I'm crazy and I'm, you know, I'm Noura. I'm crazy. And she calls it Noura-mal.
Tommy and Janet win reward in the form of more time with their loved ones.
Dan.
Lauren.
Oh my God.
Lauren, come on over.
I'm the only Vokai that's here with you guys right now. I've been loyal to these people since the beginning. I've shown my allegiance. I'm helping them get to the end. But now I know where I rank in that group. I am, in a way, the Karishma, but I'm actually enjoyable to be around. I'm funny. I'm providing. I'm cutting coconuts. I give up rewards so they can freaking eat and kill me today.
Like, Noura, you're their bitch.
I'm their bitch. I am honest and loyal to a fault. And here's the fault. Here's the fault. If blindsided me today in the face, like not blindsided me, it literally punched me in the face. We can literally control the next vote because I will be with you guys. And I'm a very transparent player. Like with me,
I take people to insane levels. I literally uplift someone to a point where he's rocking and he goes back to his ex and I'm disposed of, even though I break up with him. But the point I'm trying to make here with my surrender flag is I am in. I'm all the way in. I'm not just saying this. I want you to understand, like, I'm here with you. I'm here with you, Elaine. I'm here with you, Krishma. We have to make a move and we have to dismantle them. I see it clearly now. I have to make my move. And my sister said it. This is my crazy Noura. She always finds a way, and my family knows that. I am the epitome of a survivor in my own life because the biggest, this is where it comes to a close, the biggest obstacle of my life has been me. Am I gonna be a sheep to the end? I'm not. That's not who I am. And that's why the game is gonna change today. This is a really big boat. But it feels cool that I get so much power in it.
The Love One Reward Challenge. Is you are playing with Survivor Dynamite. You win, you get love.
I mean, there's four people left back at camp, all sharing the misery of heartbreak.
And this is what I did. If it served me well, great.
We cannot trust
it. Elaine.
I'm gonna say it right now. I'll make it very clear, and then we don't have to do all this whispering. Dean, since the day I met you at Lyro, you've shown me not once, not twice, three times, I can't trust you. Look, Dean, Elaine, and Krishma, they're on the bottom, they're trying to get in with our group. And it's like, and I would actually consider leaving my crew to go with you. You're telling me, come with us, let's do this ruse. Now, it's 110% never.
But
the plan
we
was that all three of them are gonna vote Tommy, and Elaine has an idol.
Noura got caught in a lie, and she's trying to talk her way out of it.
I will say this, I did not instigate this. Actually, Dean did when he started talking to Tommy. And smiling at him, he's laughing. Dean, don't look at pretty Dean. He just wants to like lure you in with his pretty face, but he's full of it. I'm just speaking my truth. I'm sorry.
Yes. 13th person voted out, 7th member of our jury, Karishma.
Damn, Dean pissed me off so much. Like, Dean messed up the whole plan. And so everyone thinks it's my fault. I can't believe I considered working with this guy that I've said from day one cannot be trusted. So Dean has this prized pair of shoes. It's like the cleanest, nicest looking thing of an article of clothing on anyone in the game or in life. And I'm like, you know what? I'm gonna give him something annoying to end his day on a high note for myself. So I literally put them at the top of the flag in a place where he can't reach because I'm taller than him. There's a bunch of articles of clothing of all the lost souls from the game, pun intended. And his souls were sitting right up top next to go.
So Noura, where are we in the game right now?
At tribal council?
Rob and Sandra say, our land is your land now, and you guys get to enjoy this house we made, beds, so much fruit, comfort, chickens, blankets, pillows, hammocks. I was loving it. I felt like I got upgraded to like the suite of the hotel, and now I can really drive hard to the end of the game. Janet is very loved by everyone, but we have one weasel left, and that's Dean. Dean is like the ex-boyfriend that's slick that you cannot trust. You don't know what you're gonna get with him. He's like a mixed bag of tricks. Quite simply, for my game, it's actually a no-brainer. Let's get rid of Dean.
Dean wins individual immunity.
I'm gonna take Noura.
Yes. Wow, thank you so much.
Let's do a cheers, because
Yes, yes.
Okay, so I wanna thank you for putting our differences aside, and let's have fun, and including me in it, I really, you are a man today in my eyes, and I know I've called you a boy before, but I see you as a man today, and I love the person that you are showing up as.
Noura.
When Dean chose me, I felt like I was walking into a date.
It's weird, for a guy who says he's shy, he's pretty slick and warm, and this whole beautiful romantic date, the flirting, I loved every second of it. He's cute, he's pleasant, he's gentlemanly, and I don't know, he's like growing on me.
If you win tomorrow, who are you picking?
I will take you.
Yeah?
I promise. I'm committed to you. You have my word. Taking all the romanticism and fun aside, you know, he's trying to secure his game and be in the final three. He's buttering me up for sure. And I'm liking it. And to me, it makes sense. Like, yeah, this is the best for our game. We needed to get Janet out. She's too well-liked and respected. She's got to go out as soon as possible.
16th person voted out. Janet.
I'm just gonna be fair and honest with you.
You always are.
I can't decline. And I'm not saying that because I want a guaranteed seat. I can't do it.
It feels nice that I'm a hot commodity right now. It's like I'm answering the phone and I'm like, hello? Tommy calling, hello? Dean calling. Man, like, Nora's becoming popular now. I mean, now... Sorry, I see pretty Dean stretching and going in the water. He's freaking everywhere. Now I'm the lost for words. It's finally about me. It's finally about my game. It's finally about what serves me best, not trying to make things so much easier for everyone else.
Noura wins her third individual immunity and guarantees herself a spot at the final tribal council.
I'm proud of myself. Like, look what you're capable of. Look what you can do. You know, in the beginning of the game, I thought I'm gonna be the first person voted out. And look what you can do when you really believe in yourself. I did the impossible. Because you are such a threat in the eyes of everyone, I have to tell you, it's gonna be you going to fire. Dean, you're on fire right now. Literally, you're gonna be on fire tonight. For me, this journey has been about appreciating every single step. And to complete a very challenging challenge like that and know that I did it, it's everything. It shows you have so much more in you than you know. And I'm feeling like, yes, I'm final three. This is everything.
So
and
your motive is clear. You're looking for somebody that can try to take out Lauren.
That's it.
There it is. Dean has done it. Dean has made fire.
I was close.
We'll take the final spot at the final three.
It's a little weird to wake up on day 39 because I started off feeling like I'm going to be the first one to go home. And now I'm sitting pretty in final three. And I'm here. It's weird, but I'm proud of my game. I look back and I can see the strategy. Like, I played in the moment. And I'm not going out until I give it my everything. That's what I do in my life. That's what I've done in this game. That's why I'm here right now. I think these guys think they have it in the bag, and I think they've got another thing coming. No one has ever played a game like me. I did it my way. I did it the Noura way. It's up, it's down, it's in your face. It's not replicatable. That's how you win the million. Be a disruptor. Say things that people don't see coming, and when you paint the pretty picture and recapitulate your game, they say, bravo. For me, this is Noura. I'm not a player that you've ever seen before. I am a wild card. I am a person of love, but I can be weird and crazy and say that hurts. And I've done everything I can in the game to use tools to win challenges. And I'm proud to just be here. No matter what happens tonight, when I was me to the fullest, I really felt like I thrived. And I connected socially, and it helped my strategic game, and it helped me get to where I am right now. So thank you.
The winner of Survivor, Tommy.